So how exciting is it having a winner-take-all game seven at home?
It's extremely exciting. You know, I think we're all excited to see the atmosphere. You know, we know it's going to be amazing, so it's going to be fun to play in.
How do you try and not make this bigger than what it is and try and treat it like any other game?
I mean, I don't think you can. You know, it's a game seven against a defending champ. So it's going to be, you know, a ruckus show in there, so we just got to go out and handle our business.
You played a lot of small ball five over the last couple of years. How ready were you for that, and did you bring that to the coaches at all?
I was extremely ready. You know, it's something that we have been, you know, tampering with throughout the season, so it's not like it was new for everyone. I think everybody kind of knew where I was going to be and what I was going to do at the position. So, you know, kudos to the coaches and them for believing in me and teammates and stuff like that. So, yeah.
Mike's talked about, you know, the MMA reference. You guys aren't going to win by decision. You need to knock them out. How has that hit your guys' ear, and how has that manifested on the court?
I think we've all bought into that. We know that, you know, we're a younger team, up-and-coming team. Don't get a lot of, you know, I'm not going to say respect, but a lot of calls that, you know, maybe another team would have. So we just got to continue to go out there and fight and play through it and not complain about, you know, calls that we should be getting or calls that shouldn't be getting called. So we just got to continue to go out there and fight and play for one another, and the rest will handle itself.
Speaking of the MMA analogy, what did you think of Domas' eye?
Man, you know, it just goes to show how hard this series is being fought. You know, it was an inadvertent elbow, I think, and, you know, it just goes to show how hard he plays, being able to play through something like that, and, you know, you got to use your eyes to play. So, you know, for him to be able to continue to play through that and play well through that, you know, we're extremely appreciative, and it just goes to show his toughness as a player and an individual.
Trey, what's that eye looking like today?
It looked a little swole, but, you know, he said he was fine, so he put some ice on it, and I'm sure he'll be fine.
There's an idea out there that you guys have been pushing so hard on the offensive side. You're the younger team, and at the back end of the series, the schedule gets tight. Outside looking in, it feels like they are getting a little bit run ragged, but you're out there on the floor. Like, are you feeling it? Do you buy into that idea?
I mean, I don't know if y'all see, you know, Jordan and Steph and Clay. They're out there running like they 19, 18 years old. So, you know, we can't, you know, try to hold on to that. We just got to continue to go out there and do what we do, which is run. And, you know, if they can keep up, then kudos to them. But we're going to continue to do what we do.
Was there anything surprising about what you guys were able to do yesterday?
No, I don't think surprising. I think, you know, that was probably our best game of the series, where we locked in for 48 minutes straight. And there were no lapses anywhere, I don't think. And it showed in the end. So, you know, it was a good game, but we got to continue to come out with that energy and that effort tomorrow.
With a game like that last night, how much confidence does that get you guys heading into tomorrow's
game? I think a lot of confidence, but, you know, like I said, they're the defending champs, so we got to respect them, but we got to continue to go out there and do what we did and, you know, let the rest fall, you know, where it falls, and we can only control our effort and, you know, how hard we play. So that's what we're going to do.
As a kid, how much did you ever grow up thinking, oh my gosh, game seven in the postseason?
You know, that's something that you hope for as a fan when you're watching this game seven, because you know it's going to be the best game of the series more than likely. So, you know, this is my third one that I've been a part of, and the other two were extremely, you know, great games. So I'm expecting nothing less from this one.
Great. Your guys' defense numbers weren't great tonight. It seems like you guys have definitely taken another level from a physical standpoint. What's been different for you guys in the postseason?
I think having a solid game plan for knowing we're going to play this team up to seven times helped out a lot with the guys. And then I think we're trusting one another a lot more, especially, you know, help side and on-ball stuff. And guys are trusting that we're going to be in the right spots, and I think that showed yesterday. So we got to continue to do that tomorrow.
There was that win in February in overtime in Minnesota where Domas fouled out and you played small ball five. Had you played much small ball five since then, and had you behind the scenes been kind of like, hey man, let's spread this out and up the tempo a little bit?
There were a couple games after that game that I played, you know, spare minutes there at the small ball five. So it was something that, you know, I think the coaches, you know, knew they could rely on, and something that I was comfortable with. So last night, them doing that just kind of helped out the team, I think.
How much has your ability to shoot from the outside, how much has that helped the spacing?
I think it helps a lot. You know, when we got, you know, guys like De'Aaron and Malik that can make a lot of plays and you know, allow them to have more space, it's easier for them to do the things that they're capable of doing. So I think it helps out a lot.
How essential is it to still maintain a presence on the glass when that's happening, and what do you need to do in those moments?
It's extremely, you know, important for us to do that. They're a great offensive rebounding team, and if we go small, I think everybody, you know, I think as it showed last night, was locked into boxing their man out and going to get the rebounds and not just relying on the bigs to take care of it. Everybody helped in that area.
What adjustments do you expect the Warriors to make?
I'm not sure. I'm sure they'll probably, you know, try to throw a couple more subs and make some different, you know, game plans when it comes to screens and stuff like that. But, you know, we just got to continue to go out there and play hard. And no matter what they throw at us, we got to push through and continue to fight.
Notice any fatigue from the Warriors
last night? I didn't personally, you know, like I said earlier, you know, Steph, Clay, and Jordan, those guys are out there running around still like crazy. So, you know, we'll see tomorrow.
Coach credited you for kind of taking away the pocket on the defensive end. Like, what is the key to that? Is it hand placement?
I think it's just physicality of getting into the ball with both the guard and the big. Domas did a great job with it as well. So we just got to continue to do that, be physical in the screener roles and try to disrupt them.
Thank you.